Several times in development, I've run into the need for full-screen particle effects. Recently, I decided that I wanted some dust particles floating in the sunlight poking through the canopy in a forest. While a fully 3D effect would be necessary for a 3D camera, the isometric pixel art view affords us an optimization trick. It's a technique I've used previously when making the rain effect. As isometric cameras don't have any foreshortening, translational camera motions only result in bulk translational movements of the particles on screen. This means that particles can be entirely pre-rendered to an animated texture. For effects where the particles are small and move uniformly, the texture does not have to be large for the effect to be convincing. The only requirement is that it tiles perfectly in space and loops perfectly in time. We can build such a tiling loop inside a 2D compositing software of our choice. In After Effects, I create a 30 frame per second 128 by 128 composition and configure a particle system to emit uniformly within a flat plane at a constant rate over time for a total of 64 frames. As this is a pixel art effect, I create a white square particle, set the size to be a single pixel, and disable anti-aliasing. I then have the particles fade in and out of existence as they are created and destroyed. In order to have the particles tile over space, I create four identical clones of the particle system, but offset the origin into the four corners of the image. In order to have the tiling particles now loop in time, I duplicate the tiled composition and move one copy 64 frames ahead of the other copy, such that the end of one iteration fills out the beginning of the next iteration. This technique works as long as particles do not travel a span of more than 128 pixels over their lifetime, or live for longer than 64 frames. Otherwise, we would have to make more duplicates of the particle system in order to capture the larger motion of the particles without clipping. The full looping animation is now 64 frames long, and for a 128 by 128 pixel composition, this fits within a 1024 by 1024 texture sheet, which I export out as a PNG. While the tiling and looping may seem obvious when played back directly, the effect is far more deceptive when coupled with dynamic masking, such as when I modulate the particle brightness by the beams of sunlight in the game. The only thing left is to move the texture on screen depending on the movement of the camera to give the illusion that the particles are embedded in the world. This technique works well for 2D games and 3D games with orthographic projection, and can save on particle computations, replacing them with a single UV calculation and the texture fetch. Thanks for watching.